As you know, my name is Ruth Sax. Today I am blessed because I can celebrate with you. As I look at my life today, I know that I'm the luckiest person on earth because of my dear family and friends that I'm surrounded by, and because I have lived the past 65 and more years on the best place on earth, the South Bay of San Diego. To this I say, thank you, God. I am one of the few survivors of the Holocaust, not from one or two, but from three camps. I'm not sure if you have ever met a Holocaust survivor, so here I am. Remember not to forget. You can see that the world never learned, and that today people are getting killed because of their beliefs and way of life. The people who suffer the most are the surviving families. Between my birth and until I was 10 years old, I had a nice childhood. I was lucky to have everything I wanted. I was an only child, and yes, I was very spoiled.
What are the chances, if you would have had a brother and sister, would they have survived?
Probably not. I was 10 years, and on the 14th of March, 1939, my mother's birthday, we never cut the cake. We went to my father's factory, and he represented, and lo and behold, there was his supervisor, his dear friend, wearing a swastika on his lapel. He tried to get into a cab, but were told the Jews could not get into cabs and to take the train. Between 11 and 16, 17 years old. That was the year I was in a concentration camp.
You have to remember that she witnessed this at the same age that you are right now. She told me some amazing stories, so that's why we wrote a book. And she's really bright. She actually said today, oh no, the outfit on the back cover is what I'm wearing today. So if you look carefully, these were the notes that either my grandfather or my mother wrote. Here's another card, I believe my grandfather wrote this one. The family store, there's Ruthie. She was a year old. This is a star that needed to that they wore. And if you didn't have this on, there was no Velcro, so you couldn't like change it. So you either had a pin. This is what she wore the day before she went into the concentration camp. This is the outfit. This is what they wore. And you always look for a dress that had lining in it. My mother would take Brando and spit. So whatever she wasn't eating, she was rolling. So she made like a little Torah. And here you can see the head of a cook and his leg. This is in the book, but this is a much better photo. Here are the survivors, and this probably would make me cry because in that photo there's about five of them that have passed. And we must remember to never forget. Thank you so much.
Thank you.